Ladies and gentlemen, I consider this as a very special privilege to meet all of you. I'd like to thank Mr. Chandra Mohan for giving this very special opportunity of meeting you. Hello, my name was my colleague when I was like suburban superintendent of the police. We are the one who put up the first when traffic signals were not known near the airport. So, the most important thing in our life is to find our own place in this world. On this earth, everybody has his place. Right, Chandra Mohan being the managing director of a company. Ilango, my friend, being a managing director of his own company. He's a very inspirational friend. Ilango, that's why when they said Ilango is coming, I thought I'll also come and meet you here. So, they are very keen that I must come and meet you. And I took this as an opportunity that I am meeting all of you. Perhaps if I don't meet you today, I may not meet you again. Till as long as we do not know. The point is that the most important thing in the life I found the work in the police department. There was a choice. I was actually a bank officer when I chose to join the police service. And at that point of time, I was drawing twice the salary of a police officer. I chose to give up that job, which was more lucrative, to join the police service. Today, I am very, very grateful to this police department. 25 years, it is this department. It is this department which has given me this uniform. You are in some other uniform, I am in some other decorated uniform. This government has given to me. This government has given me an air-conditioned vehicle to move. This government has given me the responsibility of supervising, guiding, motivating, developing more than 16,000 officers and men. Therefore, I am grateful. I am extremely grateful to the organization which has given me so much honor. The message is that every one of you should be thankful, grateful to the organization to which you work, because they have shown, they have provided a place for you in this world. Japanese, they say, are more loyal to the company, to the company they work. They say in every company there's a company song early in the morning, like a national anthem. They sing the company song before they start the work. Even if another company offers them a little more money, they say they may not go. It may be the story a little earlier. Now maybe Japanese are also changing, like the people of the United States. But the question of loyalty, Indians are known for their loyalty to the salt. Do you know, have you heard in our villages? In our villages, they say, faithful to the salt. Do you know that? The man who has given you the salt, you should be more grateful to your father, to your mother, to your teacher. The man who has given you the employment is much more important. Therefore, gentlemen, the company which you work, Chandra Mohan says, CMG, the company has made you more a proud person, a creditable person, a knowledgeable person, more skilled person, a better interpersonally skilled person. Therefore, we should be grateful to the organization, faithful to the organization we work. Every time people try to improve themselves, one of the purposes of this function is also to motivate. The staff who have done extremely well, better than others. I am a student of history. Bangladesh, the whole of South Asia, they conquered this country, very few people, hardly hundreds of people from England. You know, when they came to India from England in 1640s, they traveled for 4.5 months in wooden ships. They came to Chennai for a job. Today, Indians are going to London for job. In 1600s, 17th century, people from England came to India, young 13 years, 14 years, 15 years. They came, they worked, they left. Earlier account says, out of the 100 people who came to India, hardly 25 people returned alive back home. 75 people died of war, of diseases, of sickness. Those people came to India, they conquered India. You know why? Because they're generals. Generals, you can equate them with present day, you know, chief executives, chief operating officers and managing directors. They rewarded their staff
with a medal. In the short war, the man, the general who won the war, one of the Indians, he won a medal. His name was Mardanayaga. Mardanayaga. He was a Tamilian. But then he won wars after war with the British. So Robert Clive honored him like a meeting like this. In a meeting like this, like a meet. And he gave officer and a skillful officer and a faithful servant. This is to reward courage. You must reward the courage of the person. This is to reward courage and to remember for posterity that the next generation next must remember that there was a man who lived called Yunus Khan. The man who fought the war bravely. The man who has helped to establish British rule in India. This is to reward courage and to remember for posterity the name of the brave soldier. Skillful officer. All of you are supposed to be skillful. Your skill level must improve next year. Kaizen, continuous improvement. This is what the Japanese say, Kaizen, improve next, better than the present situation. That is why Mr. Ilango is brought in. Yes, Panacea, to improve your communication skills, interpersonal skills, social skills, human skills. That's very, very important. Even for a driver, skills are more important. Not only skills, his ethics, his character is also important. Somebody, you may hire a driver who is excellent in driving. Nobody can beat him. But in the evening, end of the day, if he is stealing 100 liters of petrol or diesel, can you call him a good driver? No. Character. You understand? All right, his character is good, very nice person. He will drive very well, but he will go and park your vehicle in the middle of the road and go. The man who is coming from the rear, he'll hit against the truck and the person dies. Can you call him a good driver? Social responsibility. This is what you are going to be trained by Ilango here. Therefore, it's very important that you reward. Recognize, not only reward, it's not the money that you are going to get. I am very sure you are not going to get your 100,000 rupees as cash reward. You may not get it. What is more important is recognition for the work. We all work for the recognition. Even in the police department, all of us, we don't work for the salary. Salary is only a part of the reward. The true reward is the reward we get in the form of a recognition. When we solve a case and restore 100 sovereigns of jewels to the person who lost it, he smiles at you and thanks you, right? The person who was cheated by another person of all his properties, he'll come and thank you very much, sir. Last week one fellow came, he paid 15,000 rupees to get an admission in the medical college for his daughter. 15,000, just imagine. 15 lakhs, sorry. When he got the money back, he came back and told me, sir, thank you very much, sir. I am running a spectacle company. Do you need any spectacles? I'll give you free. I don't know any spectacle free. But the point is that the true happiness is recognition. That you will get in what you are getting today in this company. At this juncture, I have a message in the form of a skill development. First of all, I told you, you must be extremely happy that you are employed in one of the best companies. You must be thankful to the company, I told you. You should be extremely happy person. We find in many walks of life, people totally unhappy sitting in the offices. I don't know, some of them are very unhappy. I tell them, you can have 100% reason to be happy because you are born in this world, first of all. What if you are not born in this world? Just think about it. Do you know the science? Science says the possibility of you being born to your own father and mother. The possibility of you being born to your own father and mother is 1 divided by 3,000 billionth of a time. That means in your own mother's womb, somebody else would have been born in your place. The combination of sperm and ovum combination is 1 divided by 3,000 billionth of a time. So you are a very, very rare creature. Number one. Number two, you are born in this earth in the most appropriate, happiest time of all. If you are born 300 years before, the possibility, you know, possibility of you dying even as you are born is much more. You understand? Even when India got independence, our life expectancy is only 22 years. When India got independence in 1947, the possibility of a baby born in India living is only 22 years. Today it is 67 years. Diseases, war. There was no heart bypass surgery those days. Now you have a heart attack, you can go to the hospital, have a bypass surgery done, next you are all right. There is no treatment for kidney failure.
There is no treatment for lung failure or liver failure those days. Today is a very peaceful place. World is a peaceful place. A lot of medicine, treatment, vehicles, cell phone, television, internet. Do you think we had all these things 200 years before? You are born in the most pleasant period of their life. Therefore, feel happy about it. And happiness, from where does happiness come? Happiness comes from money. We all admit, right? Everybody admits. But money alone cannot give you happiness. Yes, I also admit that to some extent, material health, material wealth gives happiness. That's what we fight for, salary. But imagine a situation. Salary alone can give you happiness. Then who can be the happiest man in the world? Bill Gates. Bill Gates must be the happiest man in the world because he has a lot of money. Somebody told me if Bill Gates wanted to retire today with his property, he can get 1,500 crores Indian rupees every day for the next 1,000 years. But do you think Bill Gates is sleeping and having his drinks and he's sleeping with a couple of women in Miami Beach? Do you think so? Do you think he wakes up early morning at 10 o'clock and goes to bed at 5 o'clock in the evening? Somebody told me Bill Gates gets up early in the morning at 5 o'clock. He retires from the work at 11 p.m. in the night. If money can give happiness, he must be holidaying in worlds every one beach after the other. But he is not doing that. He is working because, simple logic, happiness doesn't come from his money. Happiness comes from his work. Work gives you happiness. Happiness is something to do. Whatever you do, a new way of doing, you are doing. Your manager comes and appreciates you. That gives you happiness. You have done extremely well in the last 1 year. You are being called and you are rewarded by your own MD or by a chief guest. That is happiness. So therefore, happiness comes from whatever you do. Therefore, try to find happiness from work. That's very, very important. Try to be a work-related person, a man who can derive happiness from work. There is nothing in this world called something for nothing. People still believe that you can get maximum benefit with the minimum effort. This is our Indian philosophy. Less work, more reward. That's what we expect. People, whenever I go to the school and colleges, they say, sir, what is the secret of your success? As if there's a shortcut way I can teach them so that they can become rich and powerful. Gentlemen, I tell you, there's no shortcut for success. There's no shortcut, no way. There's no theory called something for nothing. There is no free lunch. You will get reward in commensurate with what you have done. That's all. There's no other way. I know. Even, you know, if somebody gives you lunch, there's a price. Nothing in this world is free. This is what I have learned in the last 25 years. Nothing in this world is free. Everything has got a price. You will get a reward only when whatever work you are given, you will get reward. If you really want to achieve something, if you really want to be rewarded, you put in that effort. That's very, very important. I know many youngsters coming and telling, sir, get me a job. In a private company, you know somebody else, please get me, talk to them and get a job. One fellow came from a native place, he's a chef. I told chef, it's very easy to get a job. Yes, sir, you may know people, hotels, you please put in a word, sir. Then somebody I knew, I told him, okay, a boy wants to be a real chef, he's qualified, he's a diploma in, what is that, catering, will you give him a job? And after 1 week, he came back. He told me, I told your name that you are the joint commissioner here, still they are asking me to work after 10 o'clock. I told him, in the hotel, work starts only after 10 o'clock. He wants to go back after 10 and sleep in his house. But hotels, in the restaurants, work, they'll ask him to continue till early morning, 1 o'clock. He's not willing to work. He wants, because I am so-and-so's known person, let me go. People, you know, I was in Coimbatore, five people came, all engineers. They wanted to take action against his company's MD. They wanted to put him in jail. I said, what is the point? So he gave an advertisement that he'll pay 25,000 rupees per month. 3 months he paid. Next 3 months he worked, he didn't pay the money, sir. Now what happened? The company has closed. The last 6 months, we have been asking the 25,000 rupees per month. He's not giving. We have gone to the collector, we have gone to the commissioner, we have sent a petition to the governor, president. What happened? Nothing happened. Now they told, you are a very efficient police officer. What do you want is punishing. put him in jail. I told him, he employed you.
Yeah.
How many other people? He employed about 50 people. What happened to his company? I immediately guess people of this nature, if a person employs, what will happen to the company? Company will necessarily close.
The company is closed. He has incurred a loss of 15 crores of rupees. He has no money to pay.
This point of time, what will you gain if I arrest him and put him in jail, first of all?
No, sir, that is not the point. 6 months, we are not going to any other work. We are after him. Please do that.
See the attitude of the people.
A man, poor fellow, started a business, tried to give employment. He's lost. He has closed the company. And what will he get by punishing him?
Do you know what would have happened if the situation happened in Japan?
Those engineers would have told the managing director, sir, please don't worry. We all started a company.
You continue the company. We'll work.
We'll work free of cost for the next 1 year. Let the company grow. We all will grow. We'll take a bigger share in a later date. We are willing to support you.
Here the attitude is different. Most people, they don't want to work. They are all entertainment-oriented people. How many days will you give me rest? How many days? 5 days I'll work. 5 o'clock means I will go at 5 o'clock.
Friends, I have seen a lot of successful people. I will give you a very, very small secret. As far as work is concerned, at one point of time, in the beginning stages, if you work more than what you are paid for, it's a very simple philosophy. If you work more, many people say, how much salary I am getting? I am getting 4,000 rupees. Okay, I will only work this much. After all, you are giving only 4,000 rupees. That other school, they are giving 8,000 rupees. So I will only teach this much. I will learn only this much. I will not only, give this much profit. That's all. Services. But the inner philosophy, think over. Even if you're a teacher, if she says, I am only giving lesser money in this school, I will only teach less, she will not improve her knowledge. She will not improve her skills. She will not become a better teacher any time, so that another school will hire her for a better salary. You understand? If you work more than what you are paid for, a day will come, you will be paid more than what you are working for. Earlier, from the government, I worked for one of the government companies as a vigilance officer. From the government, I got as a vigilance officer. There was a chief executive who was looking after finance of the company for the last about 15 years. Very, very hard worker. Actually, the company revolves around that finance head, mostly. He was paid 60,000 rupees. I know this, his salary. His stage has come, another company offered him 2 lakhs. So he was about to go. You know what the company did? They had an annual general body meeting. They decided to offer whatever he's asking so that he can be retained in the same company. He's still alive. If you want me, I'll give the name. If you come to me, I'll tell his name. The company is paying him 3 lakhs Indian rupees per month today. 15 years of hard work. He never thought about the salary. He was only getting 25,000 rupees, 30,000, 30,000, 50. At the fag end, he was getting 60,000 rupees. Today, this same company, it's a government company. He's paying him 3.5 lakhs Indian rupees. I understood the principle. If you work more than what you are paid today, a day will come. You will be paid more than what you work for. Wish you all the best and thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you.